Of old King Pharaoh, God's people toiled enslaved in bondage to that wicked king to lay down in the grave. They cried to God in heaven, our load is hard to bear. Let them go, thus saith the Lord, and the world shows mighty power. Pray on, a little longer, children. Work on, it won't be Exodus coming. God's gonna lift your heavy load. God turned the water into blood. Darkness clothed the land, and all the wicked felt the touch of the Lord's almighty hand. On Egypt lost their firstborn. Death claimed King Pharaoh's son. Then he let God's people go.
Hello again, this is PG. We're on part two. If you'd like to follow along, there's a link in the description. You can click on that. It'll take you to Resistance Chicks. And the address is resistancechicks.blogspot.com. It will go well with you. Prophecy, the glory of God. This is my second blog, three blog series. And 1A, I pretty much read the prophecy by Amanda. And I'm just going to go on and continue where I left off. So the bad people, the wicked people, they decided to change all people worldwide. Stop us from being independent, free farmers. Stop us from being mothers and fathers. Stop us from using real gold and silver coins because it's God's money. It is honest money, and most people are honest. And this separated us. Once you become dishonest and use fiat, you're separated from God. I mean, it's an abomination to God to use anything other than solid 99% gold and 99% silver. The knowledge of God, you're separated from the knowledge of God, and they did this to make everyone slaves to them. They started using, gave us this counterfeit money, and they saw money, the solid 99% silver, 99% gold. And if you don't do that, then you'll be punished by God. It's all over the Bible if you read it correctly. So they gave us the counterfeit money and separated us from God. So we became a corrupted nation. We no longer had a covenant with God because we deceived each other and we were being deceived. We became a communist country and we had no real money. You can say it's backed by gold as much as you want, but that's just not true. You're not. They printed more paper than they had gold and silver. It was all deception. And we were all made slaves. Then all the money you made, you had to give it back to them by buying from them. They do not do anything. You know, we do all the work. The slaves do all the work. They own the electric companies, the telephone, automobile companies. These enterprises were monopolies. It's just in their nature that they must be monopolies. And this is how you know it isn't from God. God did not give anyone the right to be that powerful over their fellow men. It's a rape of the soul. And this is somebody here saying help. Now, I blame my parents for a long time. Do not blame them. Corrupt people, especially those who took over our country, their own parents, relatives who were deceptive. Everybody started doing this everywhere. There's lots of people in your family that were deceiving you. Government has been breaking my parents down since they were born. Same with you and every good person on earth. The bad people and children see what's going on and they have signals. They have eye looks they give each other. And they're most obvious if you're alert. And then they have hand signals and keywords, etc. Secrets they keep from the rest of us. And they become pipe pipers and they lead everybody astray. And we, the people, end up hooked to their grid, hooked to the electricity, hooked to the telephones, hooked to the everything, the water company, you name it. The way you do your fiat, mortgages, leases, cars, we're hooked to the system. We're just insects in a spider's web trapped. And they poison our minds, they poison our bodies, they poison. They've been doing this for 100 years. When healing my own mother and brothers, starting in 2004, using the love and power of God, I heard rumor one of my sister was so mad. I was destroying all the hard work she did in her childhood and her entire life to change me, my mother, my brother, from whom God had created us happy and well. Saints, full of life and happiness. With brokenness comes mental damage and extreme health problems. A very kind person becomes violent, self-harmful, self-condemning, low self-esteem, and can be very harmful to others. Well, she had broken all of us, and God was fixing the people she had broken. But God's love heals and restores. People can recognize the love of God and feel God's wonders, Holy Spirit working within them, changing people. That is what happens when the wicked attack the good by doing the wrong thing. They falsely accuse other people, they're lying, and so much more. And it's consistent. They consistently do this. It is witchcraft. It's rebellion to God. This is why the Bible says to not suffer a witch to live or a warlock to live. They harm everyone. They break people down, causing great suffering. The Declaration tells us history has proven when evil is tolerated, the people suffer, meaning we throw off witches and warlocks and tyranny because we all suffer. We need to go back and repent and stand up and say, no, I will not help evil, wicked people continue breaking me or others. For this reason, God gives us power to stop wicked people harming us and harming others. They do not have the right to affect people in this way. It takes being led by God's Holy Spirit, using the Word of God and the Holy Spirit to convict them of their crimes. There's a power God gives you. You can do this, but you got to know you have that power. You don't do it on your own power or personal power. And when you see somebody doing something wrong, you say so. And the Bible says, make it your aim to live a quiet life, to mind your own business, and to earn your own living, just as we told you before. In this way, you will win the respect of those who are not believers, and you will not have to depend on anyone for what you need. 1 Thessalonians 4:11-12. The goal of the Declaration of Independence is that we're all independent. You don't need each other. You don't need a telephone company. You don't need a phone company. You don't need electricity. You don't need cars. You're independent. It says you don't depend on anyone else. Honor your father and mother, and it will go well with you. Remember, go back to your childhood and love your parents with God's love, God's power, and authority that heals. That's when you're 2, 3, 4 years old. You will learn things about your parents you didn't know. God will give you words of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And when you go back there, it's going to be dark, but there's always a light at the end of the tunnel. As you stand up and you say no, and you say what's wrong with it, and to everybody around you, God will be with you, and your light comes out into your mind. You cannot go back in time and do it over. It is in your thoughts. You need to repent. Tell God you are sorry. Ask God to help you. Loving your parents with the goal for your life to be used by God as His servant, submitted to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit's goal in your mind should be from God, that each person you know is hearing God's voice within them, to know God's will for their lives, to find out their calling from God, and God will restore their gifts, their morals, the learning, having knowledge of God's ways and principles. We'll have our covenant back. We won't be separated from God anymore, which was the bad guy's whole intention, was to separate us from God. And we stop helping them. We repent, we turn from that, and then we'll be reconciled to God, and we won't be separated from God. Then we'll have this power and love in us. Not, you know what, your goal with the Holy Spirit is for people not to hear your voice or others' voices, not their mother and father's voices, not their grandparents, not their teachers' voices. All of us as a community, a state, a nation should have one goal. The direct opposite of the social engineers, the psychiatrists, the military. America, the goal of the Declaration of Independence of our founding fathers, our great-grandparents. They wrote the Constitution for the goal that all men hear God's voice in all things only. You can know for sure that God started this and he will finish it. He will continue being God. God doesn't change. God will clean your life, your parents' life, and your memory of your life you have with them. And they will be healed and loved and love you the way God intended you. And you'll love them the way God intended and they will be free. 1 Corinthians 2:12 through 13. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us by God, which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teaches, but which the Holy Spirit teaches, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. So you think your right thing to do is get up, pay your bills out every month, make sure your bills are paid on time, go to work every day, go to school, and you think this is the right thing. Well, you're being led in a worldly way in your own personal power, because none of that's in the Bible. Not one thing you do every day is in the Bible, and you use fiat dollars, and that's not in the Bible. So you're separated from God when you do all those things. All things you're doing right are okay. And that's exactly what the bankers want you to do. The wicked men want you to do. They want you to pay your bills every day. And they want you're actually a slave and you're following their directions and what they want you to do. Isaiah 63, 7 and 9. I will tell you of the kindness of the Lord, the deeds for which he is to be praised, according to all the Lord has done for us. Yes, the many good things he has done for Israel, according to his compassion and many kindnesses. He said, surely they are my people, children, who will be true to me. And so he became their savior in their distress. He too was distressed, and the angel of his presence saved them. In his love and mercy, he redeemed them. He lifted them up and carried them all the days of old. Real America, life, liberty, and happiness, everyone loved and respected. That's how real life is. Everybody's loved. Everybody's respected. The head of every man, woman, and child is God, Jesus Christ. I mean, Jesus Christ, when I was a small child, spoke to me at 2, 3 years old. And up until I was lied to and told, oh, public school is good for me. I'm the right thing to do. And I believed that lie. And I became separated from myself, from my mother, from my family, from my love for God. I lost my peace of mind. I was no longer free. I low self-esteem, low everything. God teaches us everything we need to know as small children. It is called an anointing. God's intentions that all men are gentlemen and ladies, led by God's love, which is gentle. Either men will be obeying God, domesticating the land and plow the fields, tame horses, rustle cows, train hunting dogs, herd animals, clear the land, grow your own food, using horses, not bulldozers, build your own houses, barns, fences, raise your own children. Or, men belong to Satan, the one that is the most evil, are the owners of us all, tyrants. All men become like the tyrants without God. And we all become animals in a zoo. The evil men don't do any of their own work, and then we don't do any of our own work. Tyranny, being provided for instead of God being our provider. The right-hand picture It's Zechariah 9 and 8. I will guard my land and keep armies from passing through it. I will not allow tyrants to oppress my people anymore. I have seen how my people have suffered. And we, as long as we have tyranny, there's going to be suffering. As long as there's somebody making somebody else do things their way and not, if people aren't hearing the voice of God and answering the call of God and being led by the Spirit of God, then they're suffering. Even the evil men are suffering. Men must be governed by God or they be ruled by tyrants. That's William Penn. William Penn started Pennsylvania and he started Philadelphia and the city of brotherly love, which is Jesus' second commandment. First commandment was love God with all your heart, soul, mind, and spirit. The second commandment was to love your neighbor. And William Penn made a city called Philadelphia because that's Latin for brotherly love. And that's why he made it so all denominations could love each other and get together and make the Declaration of Independence in this one place in Philadelphia. Because in every state, you had to join a certain congregation to be a part of that government, whether it's Methodist or Catholic or the Church of England, Episcopal. So each state you had to be a part of that, but and they wouldn't let people in their, even in their government or in their state if they weren't like the same religion. But William Penn believed in brotherly love, and they were able to come together in Philadelphia and able to do the war and everything because he united everybody. He wasn't alive then. He was born in the 1600s, and he was given Philadelphia in the 1600s. But we get our Declaration of Independence basically from William Penn, and his best friend was John Locke. And they both had the same philosophy, and they really sought God for God's will for government. So, ruled by God and His Holy Spirit free. Or ruled by tyrants, always fighting for your personal freedoms and rights and belongings because they're always trying to take everything from you. Bad people just do that. They just steal. They're all kleptomaniacs. You have land, they want it. You have a wife, they want it. You have nice children, they want it. They want everything everybody else has. When did tyranny start? Basically, more or less when FDR stole all America's gold coins from them. The Constitution represents free men walking and talking to God. God is the head of every man living by every word of God, owning land, farming, women staying home, raising their children, men home, farming. The Constitution of most of our states asserts that all power is inherent in the people, that is their right and duty to be at all times armed. Men must be equal with the government. Government has gold coins, and men in America must have gold coins. The government employees need to know their place, especially today. They are equal or less than the people, never above as lords. Because of these tyrants, our inheritance was stolen. We inherited from God. The land, the gold, the right to independence, mothers celebrate every day the joy of motherhood. Due to slavery of the masses, the people, fiat, even gold-backed, is slavery. Do not celebrate middle class, or they're destroying the middle class. Don't believe in that. There is only supposed to be one class of people, and that's everybody's equal. All men are to be treated equally. It is a God-given right, according to the Bible, to live in a society where all men use gold, silver, coins only. It's a right. For all people to live in a society where men only use gold and silver coins, nothing backed by anything. The kingdom of God does not come with observation, nor will they say, see here or see there. For indeed, the kingdom of God is within you. That's Luke 17, 20, 21. So those who hear my words and understand them and act upon them, then the kingdom of God will be growing in them and they'll get closer and closer to God. FDR stole husbands from the wives and their children, fathers from the children. Then FDR stole the children, then the mothers. They made compulsory education in 1930. They legalized contraceptives in 1930, and the whole thing was to control the whole family, separate mothers, fathers, and children, and mothers at work, then they don't have to have children, and they won't be having children, so they make contraceptives, so they don't have the problem with mothers can be workers and not mothers, and fathers can be workers and not farmers, and not fathers. So the elite stole everyone's life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness, because God said, take good care of the land, get married, and multiply. So they do opposite. It's rebellion, it's witchcraft. They started to oppress the people, and people are not happy nor free, nor having a life. It is touted as on the newspaper, radio, freedoms from God, a calling of domestic life on the farms. What they're free from God's calling of domestic life on the farms. They're living a free life now. Free, actually living a free life is farming the land. To be free from farming is to be oppressed by the devil or led by sin, or sin has control over you. When you're free, then you're on the land and you're farming. A life brings forth life. So when you're on a farm, you're bringing forth life. You'll multiply sheep or pigs or chickens or cows or horses, and then you're growing food. You're always multiplying. You're always bringing forth life. And then, like your father, a creator who's always bringing forth life. A life of kindness and love. Because in order to bring that life out, you have to love, and then you love what you bring forth, the life you bring forth. In a free society, men are led by the Holy Spirit. Everyone's goal is to help each other and hear and obey God's Spirit. Women with God can know their husbands and children, respect them, and love each other, and vice versa. This brings peace to souls. When men obey the Ten Commandments, honor their father and mothers, love God, the meaning of mothers and fathers, honoring their mothers and fathers, I meant to say, is to love your great-great-grandparents and your grandparents and the forefathers, like the founding fathers and the pilgrims. We call them our forefathers. Is also loving and honoring them too. And then your mothers and fathers are honoring their mothers and fathers and their great-grandparents and their forefathers also. And the promise of God, when we start loving and honoring our parents before us, the forefathers and the founding fathers and our great-grandparents, it will go well with you. It will go well with all of society. In the Old Testament, if a son rebels against the father and the mother, he's put to death. So all of society, these evil men who rebelled in the turn of the century in 1900s, this is where this was, should happen to them, because they're rebelling against the founding fathers, the forefathers, the pilgrims, and they're rebelling against their father in heaven too. It's, or we will have what we have today if you don't do the right thing. This is a scripture that in the Old Testament, if a son rebels against his father or mother, he is put to death. This is a scripture. And so all these evil men rebelled against the old system. And this is what we have today because we've never dealt with it. It's time to deal with what they did and who they are. All these criminals, the gangsters, the cartel hated their parents. They rebelled against their parents. They hated the founding fathers. They hated America's freedom. They especially hated the pilgrims and the founding fathers. Now, I learned this from the pilgrims when we went to Massachusetts. They had a Bible out and they had a legal law book. And what this is one of the laws. This is a law in Plymouth when the pilgrims had their own colony and they lived by every word of God. Deuteronomy 21, 18, 21. If a man has a stubborn and rebellious son who does not obey him and his mother and father and will not listen to them when they discipline him, his father and mother shall take hold of him and bring him to the elders of the gate of his town. And they shall say to the elders, this of our son is stubborn and rebellious, and he will not obey us. He is a profligate and a drunkard And you go on, the elders are to put this son to death. With God in society, everyone does well for generations because men fear God instead of each other. The fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. And you've heard of the pearly gates. Well, that pearl is wisdom is entrance into the pearly gates of heaven. Through these pearls of wisdom, Jesus said a wise man went and sold everything to find a pearl of great wisdom, price wisdom. Overcome evil with good. Wisdom from God is good. The reverence of God's holy word, the gospel of Jesus Christ, is the power of God. And that's just God loves me. I will turn to him and I ask him for his help, and he helps you. And this is the pearl of great price. Matthew 13, 45, 46. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like unto a man that is a merchant seeking godly pearls. And having found one pearl of great price, he went and sold all that he had and bought it. God set America free from England, from oppression, with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Men should live by every word of God and by the Holy Spirit and obey God only. That's from Martin Luther's Reformation in 1517. The Declaration of Independence and the Constitution, that came from the gospel of Jesus Christ and from the word of God. Men obeying God brought forth the Declaration of Independence, Constitution, in obedience to God. Again, obedience to the Holy Spirit and the word of God. America needs to respect Jesus Christ and reverence him and know him and honor him and reverence him as a high priest over America, as you would reverence a much older man full of great wisdom. The kingdom of God is within. God and the Lamb are the temple of the city. That's us, in us, the New Jerusalem comes down from heaven. We are the temple of God. Now we, the people, need to hear and listen and sit before and humble ourselves to listen to the forefathers, the pilgrims, the founding fathers, and it will go well with us. To listen to our own great-great-granddaddies who wrote our state constitutions. Revelations 21, 23. And the 12 gates were 12 pearls, each of the gates made of a single pearl, and the streets of the city were made of pure gold and like transparent glass. And I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God, the Almighty and the Lamb, and the city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God, that our series is called, the glory of God, it's always a light, it's always wisdom, it's always giving light to our soul. When you sin, you're in darkness. When you use fiat, you're in darkness. When a light bulb goes off and you go, oh, gold and silver is only money that you can use, then you're full of light. And a lamp, and it I see. For the glory of God, that's the glory of God, gives light, wisdom. Its lamp is the Lamb, and that's Jesus Christ, who is the very Word of God. And so we get to a point where we can say in Amanda's prophecy that was played on part 1A of this blog, in next year you can plant your flag, and by law, you lay claim to the land, to America, to Ohio, for me, and to my own great-great-grandfather's land. And there was a movie called Far and Away, and there was a rush to Oklahoma. They were giving away free land. And once you ran out with your horses, and there was a big race. You get your land, you find the flag, and you stick it in the ground. And then once you do that, you've claimed that land for yourself. And I had the wrong word there, but you just push to the side this incorporated. That's the government we have today. It's just an incorporation. It's not our government. They're just another business like Burger King or Kleenex or Comair or Toyota. A business just as corrupt as the Federal Reserve itself. They're not a president, governor, congressman, senators of our federal government or state governments. They're not department heads. They're not the military. Those are just titles to government. But this, what we're looking at, is a business. And it's stealing the name of government. It's stealing the name of president and senators and stuff. It's not real. We just push them to the side or brush. I meant to say brush to the side. I did say brush to the side. Okay, I'm not messed up there. Okay. So you brush to the side this incorporated so-called governments, whether it's Ohio, your state, whoever they are, they're pretenders. They're not real. It's all an act. They're just like a business. They incorporated themselves. So they're no longer the government of the people, a flesh and blood people. They're running the business to make money for each other and profit each other. Why they're there with this fake phony money. They make things up, they make laws up, they make rules up that aren't right. And they attack the people and they're enemies of the people. As I stated in the beginning, first paragraph. They've been stealing names just like the Federal Reserve does, but it's incorporated. The Federal Reserve isn't federal, it's not a reserve, it's not a bank. So the United States government we have today is not a government. They're not presidents, not senators. They're not department heads, they're not military, because they're totally not, they don't have a foundation, don't have the Constitution, they don't have the Declaration of Independence. They threw that away and became an incorporated business to profit themselves. They're on their own. We the people are not in that company or business establishment. They broke from the US government. Under the Pilgrims and under the Founding Fathers, that's common law. That's under God's law. Only we live by God's law and by God's spirit. We are not obligated to them in any way, shape, or form. We have a covenant with God as a country, as a state. That's why there's prayer in the Congress and in the senators and when your little state governments, everything. You pray first because we have covenant with God. We ask God's help every day to do the right thing. Because through Jesus Christ's death on the cross, the gospel of Jesus Christ, that's how come we have a covenant with God as a people to love and worship God and reverence His word only. We made that covenant with the Declaration of Independence and with the Constitution. As God is my witness, they are foreign aliens to American aliens, not space aliens, but traitor aliens, trespassers, not loyal to Declaration. And the Constitution, they are like vagabonds, wanderers, they are squatters on land that doesn't belong to them. Everything they have, and the Federal Reserve has, the corporation, the military, it is all stolen. They use us as slave labor. They do not own a thing. They cannot pass any laws for us. They're like squatter. A squatter is a person who settles in or occupies a piece of property with no legal claim to the property. A property owner who does not use or inspect their property for a number of years could lose the title to another person who makes a claim to land and takes possession of land and uses the land. And this is by Martin Luther of the Reformation of 1517. He protests against the church giving laws and rules arbitrarily, not based on what Jesus Christ said. So they're like, no, Jesus Christ is our head. We're not going to obey your laws and rules the Catholic Church and landowners have made up. And Martin Luther said, we are saved by grace alone, through faith alone, in Christ alone, according to Scripture alone, for the glory of God alone. Again, I started my series as the glory of God, and it's for the glory of God. Now, this just happened. I just read this article like last night. Three Ohio judges unexpectedly die in 9-day period following a vaccine mandate in Cuyahoga County, Cuyahoga County. It's in Ohio, it's in Cleveland. This here is the, I'm warning everybody about this golden circle. My pony is using this weird look of math lately. It calls it vortex math. It's not good, okay? It's dangerous. I like Bo Pony a lot. I want to save him from this lie and deception. But if you wanted to click on here, you can go to the article. And what happened was the board or somebody of judges said, well, we better mandate it for us. So we set a good example. And their desire, they were deceived, very much deceived. They wouldn't have done this if they knew exactly what was going to happen. Most of the people in government who get the roll up the sleever get a like saline solution or a pretend jab. They don't really get it. It's to fool people. So you know these guys weren't in cahoots with the rest of them. I guess the judges were on the wrong side of the law. If they were on the righteous side, they would have not taken the what this is. It's a transforming technology inserted into their bodies. That's what it is. The technology is to transform you and transform your DNA and transform what you are. And they would have never taken this. It is a state-of-the-art classified weapon of mass destruction owned by the U.S. military, made to protect their cryptological quantum financial system. All people must know now be transhuman, connected to machines for monetary technological advancements. So you can get your finances done just by a thought, because your whole body will be connected to an interface. We are the experimental unit to work out the bugs in the programming of human beings, merging our minds and our bodies with computers. This is for the United States of America, not the one, it's a corporation, not the, under the Constitution. The QFS, I put this up here. See, QFS is right here, I think, right there. Quantum financial system is here, and this is their plan right here. You know, Q, heard of Q, trust the plan. Well, this is the plan. This is why you have to have the technology to have a job in you. The saints, I'm telling saints, we don't need that. We can obey God. We can use gold and silver coins. We can live according to the Constitution. We can have farms and provide for ourselves. We don't need them to provide for us because we're the ones doing all the work. They don't even do any work. They make up the stuff where they can enslave everybody. But they don't go out and farm and grow their own food and raise animals. They don't raise their own children. They live inside in the dark all day long in buildings where their whole environment is controlled. Being outside is what gives you life, and it's so healthy. Okay, they're experimenting on people. Now, this here is a tourist of purpose. Well, the outer ring here is the experiment. Okay, this is just an idea. It's a presumption. It's what they want, desire to happen, but they're still experimenting to get this to work. But the whole idea, everybody will be connected with this free energy, we'll have free money, and everything, the elections, there'll be advanced technologies. Got the Space Force, got all the satellites. They say spiritual growth, but they mean the negative spiritual growth into they have to worship now electricity and free energy and energy. And there's a whole religion related to electricity since the start of electricity in the late 1800s. There is a religion that everything is religion, everything is spiritual. Religion is just what you believe, and mankind has to worship. And so then there's this seven rays of light and the legions that follow. And I didn't really study the religion real, but they call it humanitarianism. And in part one, I show you in the Reformation, a part of the Catholic Church that became humanist. And they try to start it with God, but then, of course, the evil takes over, and humanism isn't good like it was supposed to be. But that's their religion, main religion. But it's under this rays of light and frequencies and vibrations and everything's science. It's not just faith in God or the Word of God. And because of what recently happened, you're going to see this Taurus by Biosystems. Taurus Biosystem announces 25 million series, a financial finances to advance infectious disease diagnosis across healthcare settings. Because this isn't natural, it's not normal. People, human beings, their bodies will always be failing or falling apart because it's not meant to have electronics going through it. You're always going to have radiation poisoning, and electricity comes with radiation. So it's, you're always going to have these boosters over and over and over and over and over again to try and save you from it. It's not natural. It's not normal. So they got a whole, they have technology all set up, and they're setting up companies to go along with it. And you saw that was called Taurus. Well, this is called Taurus of Purpose. So these are all connected. The whole thing is all connected here. So when you see this golden circle, that's the God that they worship. It's perfection. It's like 64 units of math that added up to perfection. And then you get the Taurus and you get the equilibrium and what the earth keeps the earth alive. And I didn't get into the details. I just know the words. So when I hear it, I'll have a bell go off in my head. But they're experimenting on the people. So, but this gets back to Amanda Gray's prophecy 24:27 at the time. Next year, you will plant your flag and claim the land. For no prophecy was ever produced by the will of man, but men spoke from God as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit. 2 Peter 1:2. The one who prophesies speaks to people for their upbuilding and encouragement and consolation. 1 Corinthians 14:3. And so I want to make sure prophecy is spelled two ways. One is with a C at the end and the other one with S. And so I looked it up. Prophecy with a C, prophecy with an S. Prophecy with a C is the noun. And the prophecy with the S is the verb. So the prophecy with an S is simply to pronounce a prophecy with a C. And prophecy with a C, at its most fundamental meaning, is a message from God. Hence, to prophecy with an S is to declare a message from God. But so prophecy with an S or C is a noun, a prediction, the faculty, the function or practice or practice of prophesying with an S. Then prophecy with an S, to utter by or as if divine inspiration, to predict with assurance or on the basis of mystic knowledge. In short, we can describe prophecy with a C as a message and prophecy with an S as delivering that message. So with a C, the message itself. With an S, it's the person giving the prophecy or the act of giving a prophecy. And I have a link here if anybody wants to know the difference between what is a prophecy with a C, meaning and examples of prophecy with an S. Prophecy at its most fundamental meaning is a message of God. That's what the C, and that's a noun. And there's more to it if you want to look it up. The New Jerusalem, Revelation 21:22. This happened when Jesus paid the price on the cross. And then Jesus Christ is revealed what actually happened. What's the power of God? What happened to us? What do we do now? What's our walk with God? And there's another book called Pilgrim's Progress. And that is like a book of Revelations. Revelation is no S at the end. I always say it with an S. But God revealed to your soul and your mind. The Constitution And this is a word I got from the Lord on October 15, 2021. The Constitution heals the land. We the people enter the kingdom of God as we use this power through the pearly gates of great wisdom from God. You understand, you deeply understand the Constitution Declaration, how it comes from God. It's a unity of man, his spirit in man. It brought it forth through the pearly gates of great wisdom from God, heaven on earth. The kingdom of God is within you, and miracles will follow. There's going to be a great revival. This is coming up in the future. Very right now. And we're like this, the light or the spark that starts it. But it's going to spread like fire. Quickly. We're very dry trees. I don't know if you ever started a fire, but the drier the wood is, the faster it burns. We've been in a desert and there's been no rain. That's the word of God coming down in the understanding of God, knowledge of God. That's the water, the Holy Spirit. Jesus said, come to me, all you that thirst and are heavy laden, you know, and he fills us up and fills with Jesus' water, you never thirst again. So I'm just saying, it's going to catch like fire because we're all so dry from lack of understanding and wisdom for over 100 years on the gospel and people actually teaching the gospel. And so we'll all be burning like fire quickly because I burnt in a bicycle trip in 2003. We had to learn how to burn wet, soaking wet wood because that's all there was. It had rained all day. And we did. We got it started over time. And then you have to sit there and blow on it and fan it and everything, get it going. But if it's really, really dry wood, it just takes off. And this is just going to take off. Miracles follow. God's Holy Spirit is opening the eyes of people, setting them free. People are no longer slaves, but through Jesus Christ, free men. Now, LA, the ship's off the shore there. The grocery store is empty, the shelves. It's God. We're not supposed to buy and sell with the wicked. We're supposed to domesticate the land, answer to call God, till the soil. Do everything for yourself and with God helping you. Use any gold and silver coins. It is the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence. We wrote those documents. They're living and breathing. So whatever your fathers did before you, you can say you did too. So when the Founding Fathers did with the Holy Spirit, we did that. We're the body of Christ. We did that. So we can be proud we wrote the Declaration of Independence. We can be proud we wrote the Constitution. It's ours. We can be proud we wrote the Bill of Rights. Those are our documents. Those are our laws. And we can claim them as our own. And they came out, were birthed out of our love for God because we have a covenant with God. Our covenant isn't with men. It is with God. God reveals the truth, his wisdom. Upon this rock, I shall build my church. Revealed wisdom of God. The rock is the revealed wisdom of God. Gets us through the pearly gates, gets us into the kingdom of God within. The gates of hell shall not prevail against it. The revealed truth and wisdom of God. He will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. Revelation 21:3. This is news. You need to know this news. This is the news. This is relevant for today to get swept free from the tyranny that we're under. This is how you can protect yourself and keep yourself safe and save your family, save your neighborhood, save your community, save your state, save your country. You have to have this real relationship with God and get wisdom from God. Horace Greeley stated, it is impossible to enslave mentally or socially a Bible reading people that understand what they're reading and apply that understanding, apply the principles. The principles of the Bible are the groundwork for human freedom. The gates of hell, the lies they tell you over and over again. This is a ram, a battering ram somebody made for some Renaissance thing, I'm sure, Renaissance fair. Well, when they lie to you and they say that lie over and over, it's battering ram to your soul. And that's lies over and over. Separation of church and state, separation of church and state, separation of church. There's no such thing. Okay, that means the church hierarchy can't be over the government running the government. But it means that we, the people, live by every word of God. But they, the bad guys, they tell lies over and over and over and over again. They use a battering ram against your soul. So they tell the same lies over and over again in rebellion to God to set up their lies as truth in the minds of the people. And that's what I just watched a show with Alex Jones saying the CIA has been using the psychological warfare against the people. It's worldly wisdom. It's for the computers, the AI, the monetary system. It's all based on lies. The rock, Jesus Christ, the very word of God, the Son of God, his pearl of wisdom revealed by the Holy Spirit breaks through the lies. Jesus was born a man, conceived by Mary, his mother, and God as his father, out of God's love for his creation. We are grateful to God, our Father, for his love and his watchful eye over us. And this says, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. We beheld his glory. Glory is the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. John 1:14. His love. He wants to help us. He's there knocking on the door. Let me in, let me in. But you have to turn to him and open the door and ask, God, help me. And he'll be able to help you and lead you to the truth. And you'll get out of these lies they tell. And you'll be free. Now, in the 1800s or whatever, we built statues and monuments to honor. See, love your parents, love and honor your parents, that's its commandment. To honor great men and their sacrifices. Men before sacrificed their time, their talents, their abilities, their time they spent alone and away from their family. They sacrificed dedication to God to liberate all men, to propagate the gospel. And that's what we, statue is to honor that person. And Plymouth, there's a huge 80-foot statue, granite statue to the pilgrims, the forefathers monument. It's in Massachusetts, in Plymouth, Massachusetts. It's to honor the pilgrims and honor their sacrifice. They left everything and came to America. William Penn left everything. His father was second to the King of England. He turned back on all of it and came to a wilderness. Okay, and he sacrificed and he cleared the lands. He made good contracts with the Indians. He paid the Indians real gold and silver for the land. He didn't just take the land from the Indians, okay? But to honor their sacrifice and honor what they did, then we make statues. And this is directly from God. Okay, God told me this. I didn't know this. I thought statues were stupid, okay? But they made statues. These statues that we have, like George Washington, I saw that in Boston, I think. We did a tour of Boston, and it was to honor him and honor his sacrifice and honor his dedication to God, his dedication to freedom, to liberating other men, and to propagating the gospel and spreading this wonderful, great news of Jesus Christ, forgiveness of sins. Power was given to us by God, his very spirit, to lead us every day and live free, happy, healthy lives with God with us all the time. For God, who said, light shall shine out of darkness, is the one who has shown in our hearts to give the light, wisdom, and knowledge of the glory of God. You know, the series is called The Glory of God. It's light, it's wisdom. It's like, oh my gosh, light bulb went off. We honor these men with these statues. You know, honor your father and mother. In the face of Christ, we never be separated from God ever again. That's the good news. That's what we propagate the gospel of Jesus Christ. Live free, independent lives. Reunited with God in baptism of water, fire, and spirit. Good men with God in them, helping them, dominating the land again. Just like my family, my great-great-great-grandparents helped write the Constitution, clear the land in Ohio. Not the United States Constitution, the Ohio Constitution. My father's before me. You know, we got to honor them, respect what they did. And Revelation 21:5, and he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make things all new. That's us, what inside of us. Revelation said, New Jerusalem coming down, the kingdom of heaven, it comes, it's within us. and all things are new. And we are the temple of God, and God is in us, and he makes his temple in us, and he's our light, and he's our wisdom. I make all things new, he said unto me, write this, for these words are true and faithful. Revelations 21:5. This is the end. I'm just going to read this, so hopefully you'll understand this more after what some of the things I explained to you, because this really helped me after I got a word from the Lord. I start reading the Bible, it makes so much more sense. Romans 6. Sin's power is broken. 1. Well then, should we keep on sinning so that God can show us more and more of his wonderful grace, that he forgave our sins? Of course not. Since we have died to sin, how can we continue to live in it? Or have you forgotten that when we were joined with Christ Jesus in baptism, we joined him in his death? For we died and were buried with Christ by baptism, and just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glorious power of the Father, now we also live new lives. Verse 5, since we have been united with him in his death, we will also be raised to life as he was. We know that our old sinful selves were crucified with Christ so that the sin might lose its power over our lives. We are no longer slaves of sin. For when we died with Christ, we were set free from the power of sin. And since we died with Christ, we know we will also live with him. We are sure of this because Christ was raised from the dead, and he will never die again. Death no longer has any power over him. All that ties together with Revelations 21. This is exactly from Revelations 21. We are sure of this because Christ was raised from the dead, and he will never die again. Death no longer has any power over him. When we died, he died once. Well, excuse me. When he died once to break the power of sin. But now that he lives for the glory of God, for the glory of God, for the glory of God. So you also should consider yourself to be dead to the power of sin and alive to God through Christ Jesus. Do not let sin control the way you live. It means wait on God. Wait to hear God. Wait to be led by God's Spirit. Once, twice, all day long. Be led by the Holy Spirit. You don't have to quit anything. Don't quit anything. Just let God lead you. Trust him. He'll bring light and truth. He'll lead you to the truth, and the truth sets you free. Do not give in to sinful desires. I have the hardest times waiting on God. I want to get up and go. I want to get up and go. I want to go play tennis. You know, I want to go do yard work. I want to do this. I want to do that. But you got to just sit still and wait on the Lord sometimes so he can renew you and strengthen you and deliver you and set you free from all the lies you've been told. Do not let any part of your body become an instrument of evil to serve sin. Instead, give yourselves completely to God. For you were dead. Now you have new life. So use your whole body as an instrument to do what is right for the glory of God. Sin is no longer your master, for you no longer live under the requirement of law. Instead, you live under the freedom of God's grace. 15. Well then, since God's grace has set us free from the law, does that mean that we can go on sinning? Of course not. Don't you realize that you become the slave of whatever you choose to obey? So you're slave to whatever you, if you obey the fiat dollars and the fiat laws. And I was just thinking about, wow, Bo Pony teaches that mortgage, another word for mortgage, is basically death. And I remember I did not want to get a debt for a house, but a couple other people kind of forced me in that situation. I can't do this because I'm alive in Christ. I can't die again. So I didn't understand it until just now. I'm reading it. It's like, oh, now I know. Okay, so you're a slave to whatever you choose to obey. You can be a slave to sin, which leads to death, or you can choose to obey God, which leads to righteous living. Thank God, once you were slaves to sin, but now you wholeheartedly obey his teaching we have given you, and now you are free from your slavery to sin, and you have become slaves to righteous living. Because of the weakness of your human nature, I am using the illustration of slavery to help you understand all this. Previously, let you yourselves to be slaves to impurity and lawlessness, which ever deeper into sin, which led ever deeper into sin. Now you must give yourselves to be slaves to righteousness, living so that you will become holy. And so as you wait every day for God, the more he cleans you up and wait for the Holy Spirit to lead you, and the more you become holy. When you were slaves of sin, you were free from the obligation to do what is right. And what was the result? You are now ashamed of the things you used to do, things that ended in eternal doom. But now you are free from the power of sin and have become slaves to God. Now you do those things that lead to holiness and result in eternal life. For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. That will be the end of my blog for now. I've got another blog coming. You should look forward to that. That's when we deal with the foundation. It'll go well with you if you wait on the Lord and then let him lead you, and you'll learn to do Isaiah 58, not turn your back on your own. You learn to honor your father and mother, and you learn to honor your grandparents, and all to the glory of God. And I started to write this. I haven't even finished writing it yet. But this is the third part to the glory of God. Men built saints' kingdom, the foundation of iron and clay. This is the great image Nebuchadnezzar saw, a kingdom of gold, silver, brass, iron, and then feet and toes of clay and iron, and they don't mix well. So a rock will bring down the feet of iron and clay, and Bo Pony says that's gold. Men built Satan's kingdom, and then the glory of God will bring down that. I've got lightning striking the feet. And so you're going to look forward to that, because they were so smart. They destroyed slowly over time the foundation of America, and that's how they took over. They would say bad things about the Declaration of Independence. They'd say bad things about the Constitution. They said they lied and lied and lied about it all. They lied about the Founding Fathers. They lied about the Pilgrims. And they continually false accused all these people, but we believed them because we didn't have the history in our brains, because we went to public school. So we couldn't defend the Founding Fathers. And so through the Lord, we can get set free and stand solid ground, honoring the Founding Fathers and knowing what they really did and what they their intentions were, and the Holy Spirit was with them. But you have to know history in order to stand against these lies. They said, oh, they did this, they did this. They're just lying. They know that's not true, to break us down. But we need to be just as wise as they are, and we need to attack their foundation and bring them down. This is PG, signing off. Praise on, a little body of children, walk on, his face to see. There's one more, Exodus comes.